welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'm going to be showing you everything that I bought at my first ever Aldi shop and also tell you a bit about my experience. So I've never been before because our nearest one is about 30 minutes away, so it's not the most convenient. But after years and years of you guys telling me to try it out, how good the products are and how much money I'll save, I thought I would go and see what it's actually like for myself. So I was really excited. You know you're old when you get super excited about herbal teas and food shopping, but I went there today and I spent loads of time. And before I went, I actually wrote out on Instagram to you guys and said, what are the products that you would really recommend from Aldi? What are the things that you buy over and over again? And I have actually bought some of those. So I'll also be showing you my viewers' recommendations as well. There's a few things to note. I picked up, well, I actually went there without a list, which is probably a bad idea, but I was just so excited to just see what it was all about for myself. But I didn't have a list, and I was hungry, so I ended up buying quite a lot of stuff. I spent £84 on this shop, but I've also got everything that I'm going to need for Easter, for the boys. Also picked up loads of treats and just things that you guys recommended. So I feel like it's quite a random shop, but I have loads to show you. And I would also love to know in the comments any other products that you guys recommend. And it was a little bit thin on the ground there today because of the coronavirus. Everyone was clearly stockpiling, and some of the shelves were empty and stuff like that, but I have got quite a lot of stuff to show you anyway. But yes, I hope you really enjoy this. I'm just gonna literally talk you through it like you're around my house, and yeah, here we go. I'm just gonna start over here with some of the breads that I picked up. So many of you recommended the bread section, and especially, I think there was 5 people that messaged me to say, get the chocolate brioche bun. So I bought this. It's like one big brioche that you tear and share, and it comes in this tin here. So I thought, oh, maybe you actually put it in the oven and then serve it like that, but there's no instructions on how to heat it up or anything, so I think it just must come in that. But this was £1.59, so I'll definitely test this out with the boys. The boys love brioche anyway, so I'm sure they'll really enjoy that. Then I picked up some flatbreads. These were 75p, and I just really like having these with soups and hummus. Then I also got some hot cross buns. These were like 59p, I believe. They were really, really cheap. And then so many of you recommend that I try the tiger bloomer. So my boys love tiger bread and giraffe bread. This was 99p, and the best thing about it is it comes pre-cut. So we don't have to make a huge mess. We've already eaten a few slices of this with our lunch. But yeah, that was really, really delicious. Then the last thing that I bought in the bread section were these brioche burger buns. They also had the hot dog buns as well, but I bought these to go with the sweet potato burgers. Again, this was something that you guys messaged me over and over again, and I was excited because I'm trying to eat a bit more plant-based and just generally eat a bit less meat. Yeah, these look really yummy. They have chickpeas, carrot, red pepper, and a hint of chili. So I'm going to serve these on one of the nights for all of us. And then I also got for the boys these Italian chicken cipollata sausages. These were $1.99, and again, it was recommended to me by you guys, so I'm really excited for the kids to try them. And then I also thought I would pick up some of the chicken goujons in there. Now, these were £1.25 in Aldi, and I normally get the boys' goujons from M&S, so these are considerably cheaper, so it'll be interesting to see what the boys think of those ones. Then I also picked up one of their sourdough pizzas. Again, so many of you recommended this to me, and they had loads of different flavors, but I got the sun-dried tomato and buffalo mozzarella. And there was like a big section on it, and it said that they won the chilled pizza retailer of the year, so I'll be interested to try that out. And that was £3.25. Then I also picked up some vegetable crisps. I think that was 85p. And then I picked up a few fruits and veggies, not many, because to be honest, we went to the market this weekend and I picked up loads of vegetables, but I did get these tender stem broccolis.
That was £1.19, and then we also picked up a red grapefruit. So Matt has a grapefruit every single morning. So we just got the one because he's quite fussy about it and he wanted to test it out before he committed to buying enough for the whole week. So we've got one to try. Also picked up some Pink Lady apples for the boys. The Gala apples and like all the other types of apples I felt were like really, really reasonable. I think they were about a pound, but the Pink Lady ones were more expensive, but these are the ones that the boys really tend to like. Then I also got some blueberries and strawberries. The strawberries were only a pound, and they're definitely cheaper than where I'm currently buying them. And I thought it was quite cute that these are like the wonky strawberries. So obviously they're not gonna look perfect, but I mean, they look perfect to me. And obviously for the boys, I tend to just cut them up. So, I mean, no one's gonna care if they're slightly less attractive. Then I also picked up this curry sauce. This is a jalfrezi one, which is quite spicy, but they had all the different curries there. And again, this was recommended to me by you guys. You guys said, get the curry sauce with the spices on the top. So that's what I did. I think you heat up the sauce for about 4 to 5 minutes, and then you add the spices for another few minutes. So I'm excited to test that out because we're really into our curries at the moment. And another product so many of you guys recommended to me was this tomato and mascarpone pasta sauce. I found it so interesting that like it was so specific that you all really enjoy this product, so I thought I'd definitely try it out. It was 72p and it's just a stir-through sauce, so again, really nice and quick and easy to make for the kids. So I'll definitely serve this with garlic bread one point this week and let you know how we get on with it. Then I picked up some 100% pure Canadian maple syrup. This was £3.49 and is normally quite pricey, but you only need a tiny bit of it. But my family really does go through it because we have it on pancakes, we have it on oatmeal, we have it like if I bake certain things. So I needed some more of that. And then I also picked up some smooth almond butter. Now this was the biggest one that they had in there today because as I mentioned, so many people were stockpiling. But I've got this one and I think it was £1.69. One section that really stood out to me that I thought was definitely cheaper than other places that I've been to was all the stuff for packed lunches or snacks when you're out. So I got the Quavers dupe. These are called cheese curls. They were 85p for 10 packs. Like, that just seems insane to me. So we're gonna test them out, see what the boys think. Then I also picked up these squidgy pouches. So you get 4 pouches in here, 2 strawberry, 2 raspberry from Moshfray pouches. Now Jackson loves these. He sucks one down every single day. And they were 80p for 4 of them. And I'm currently paying 80p for just 1. So this would really save me money if he does like these. So I'm excited to try these. And then I also picked up some wafer bars. If the boys ever do have a packed lunch or we want a pudding when we're out, I normally buy like the timeout bars. But these are kind of like a takeoff of those. And they were 85p for 9 bars. So I really did feel that like all the packed lunch stuff seemed really good value. So many of you guys recommended the room diffusers and also the candles in the home section. And I had heard in the press in various places that these are really good dupes for Jo Malone. So I thought I would test them out for myself. So over here, I got the sweet almond and macaroon candle. It smells incredible. I love the pearlescent glass on it. And this was £3.50, whereas obviously the real Jo Malone candle is £50. And it has a similar sort of lid, but it is plastic, but you can still sit it on there and light it. So I'm going to test it out. I'm really excited to. And then I also got the room diffuser, which is lime, basil and mandarin, which is actually a Jo Malone scent. Like, I'm surprised that they can literally just completely rip them off like that. But again, £3.50, and the Jo Malone room diffusers are like £50 or maybe even more. But yeah, so I'm excited to try this out. And they had loads of different scents. They had pomegranate, they had rose, they had loads of different ones. So then I also picked up these super soft Mediterranean herb wraps. There's 8 in here and it was just 79p. And I've been finding that I've been having lots of wraps lately. I love them with like hummus and veg in them. Then I also picked up this seasoning mix sachet. Now I'm excited about this because it was 22p and I normally buy these for spaghetti bolognese or sausage casseroles, chicken casseroles, stuff like that. And the one that I'm currently buying is 80p. And so this is a lot cheaper. So I'll be interested to see what it actually tastes like. Then I picked up some rocket because we really like to mix rocket, onion, and new potatoes together with some salt and pepper and oil. And this was 48p, which again, I thought was really quite reasonable. And I also just wanted to take a sec to mention the random aisle in the middle of Aldi. Now, so many of you guys messaged me saying, you have to go to the random aisle, you have to go to the mystery aisle, it's like Disney, and I didn't know what to expect, but when I got there, I found that it is literally just a very random aisle with all kinds of different products. When we were there today, there were toys, there was like a Zimmer frame type thing, there was this thing that you could grow tomatoes in, like so many different things, fleece jackets for men, shoes, like it was just crazy. I'll try and insert some footage here. The only thing that I bought today in the random aisle were these bag clips. They were £1.29 and I just need them for snacks and things like that. But if you go, there looked like there were so many good toys, but my kids have so many toys, I just didn't need to get any more. But if you were like going to a birthday party or something, there were loads down the random aisle. Now we're getting into loads of treats that I got for Easter and also just for home. So the first thing I picked up were some Oreo dupes. They were 36p. A pack, so we'll test them out. And I also got a Terry's chocolate orange for Matt. This was 99p. This is like the ultimate for him. When you ask him what he wants for Christmas, he just wants one of these. So I thought I'd get him one of those. Also picked up some Kinder Joys. They were 79p each. And then I thought that this Easter egg hunt kit was actually really good. It was £2.99 and you get 25 eggs in it. You might even get other things in it. I haven't actually opened it up. Oh, there's one golden egg inside it as well. So I thought that would just be great for our Easter egg hunt at home. And then I got a few bits for the boys' Easter baskets. So I picked up these hollow bunnies. I think they were 99p each. And then I got these little nests of little chocolates. They're like little bunny characters. Then I also got some cream eggs. We got five, but Matt's already eaten one. And then some little mini Malteser bunnies as well. There's loads of individual ones in there, so I'll kind of like put it throughout their baskets, and then I'll probably add in some toys and some soft toys. And then I actually got these ones for my niece and nephew and a friend as well. So I thought it was really cute. It's called a pinata chick. So you smash it open and it's full of mini eggs. So these were quite expensive. They were $5.99, but it is a gift. And they did have all of the normal like Cadbury's Easter eggs. They were all like 99p, so they were really good value. They had the Smarties ones and stuff, but I kind of just wanted to go a little bit extra, and I thought it was quite cool that, I mean, I know that kids would just love smashing these up and then stuff coming out of them. So I got them, and I'm feeling nice and organized for Easter now. And the last thing that I wanted to show you is that I got quite a few ice lolly packs. I actually went down the frozen aisle to get the vegan ice cream because so many of you guys recommended it, but it seems that everyone had been stockpiling the vegan food in there today. They were really low on everything or completely out. But I saw all of these lollies and I thought they would be great for spring and summer. So I'll show you. So I got two packs of the tropical lollies. They were 85p each. Then I also got these little mini whirls. There's eight in here. And then I also saw these and I thought that they were like a bit special, a bit extra. Maybe if they have like friends over or something. They are unicorn cones. So I just think the kids would absolutely love that. Obviously it's a special treat. And then the last thing that I got is because you guys made me do it. Someone messaged me, they were like, get the gin ice lollies. Now I'm not a massive drinker, especially not gin, but I thought these would be so great to have in the freezer if we have barbecues in the summer. I could hand out like a gin lolly, or I might even try one as well. So yes, there is some alcohol in these, obviously can't let the kids have these, but I'm excited to try. Right guys, so that is everything that I bought at my first ever Aldi shop today. I hope you enjoyed this slightly different video. I appreciate that there wasn't like loads of meal inspiration in this, but if you're looking for videos like that, I have made so many meal prep and dinner idea videos, so I'll link them in the description down below. And thank you so much as always for watching. I love you guys, and I'll see you in my next one. Bye!